I'm just going to do a snapper draw mount. I do these mounts for the family, myself and my son Van. I've got a couple of plaques for my daughter Ellie and wife as well, but they haven't really caught any decent snapper worth mounting yet. Ellie's just still a little bit young to come out west, so that's Van's one he caught a couple of weeks ago. 7.8 pound. That was his old one. There's a 6.5 pound jaw there. My old one, 19.5, caught about 3 or 4 fish around 18, 19 pound, but today finally got my 20 pounder, so just put him in there. He is 26.4 pound. Gonna boil him up for about half an hour in the camp cooker. This little gas camp cooker there. Let him boil up for half an hour and we'll come back and show you how to get the jaw out. Alright, let's see how we're going. Oh yep, about done. Bottom section there. Section of the jaw. I'm gonna get the two top pieces. This one there. That's the other side. There we go. Now let those cool off for a bit and then we'll brush his teeth. A bit of a clean up. Missing a few teeth, this fella. Sounds like quite cool. Next stage is soaking in some bleach for pretty much overnight. That's soaking there overnight. We'll clean them up and glue it up. Should come up, man. Alright, jaws have been soaking for overnight. Look pretty good. Came out nice. Rejoin the top jaw together and then join it to the bottom jaw.
What I use is this little grip I use for work. 1 hour cure. Just put a couple of bobs of that on. It's really strong stuff. You don't need much of it at all. A bit of glue on the joins. Can be a bit fidgety sometimes. This fella looks like he might have had a bit of a crooked jaw. It's quite hard to line up. There's that. Had to make a new plaque because he didn't fit on the old one. But a bit of a shame actually, he's actually missing a few teeth in the front. He's missing a couple of front fangs, but still pretty cool. Still pretty cool draw. I'll give you an idea, that's a 26 pound snapper. This is a 6 pound snapper. Just an extra 20 pounds there. Very cool. See his big back moles in the back. You can see how they can bite through hooks. If you don't have decent hooks, they'll just bite straight through those cheap hooks. So that's what it pays to have good hooks. If you're playing these for a while, they can just crunch straight through them.